What was it about this particular story that made you so determined to be a part of bringing it to the big screen?
Well, when I first read the script was originally written in 1979. First and foremost, it was just a beautifully written piece of drama. The characters I immediately responded to, Rudy and the young boy. The Paul character was not in the first draft. It was something that I added. And so I saw it as an opportunity and a challenge to update a script to tell a 70s period piece. And also, I've experienced, as I think everybody has, I've experienced a certain amount of loss in my life. And so that sense of loss and that sense of injustice, I had experienced a bit of in my life and wanted to speak about some personal things while telling a dramatic story.
Of course, there's a very tender chemistry, I think, between Alan and Garrett's characters. Can you talk a little bit about the importance of casting them and that particular dynamic?
Well, the two of them do such a beautiful job. Alan and Garrett are able to step in really without rehearsal and immediately start to form a bond and a chemistry. And like really, really good actors, you know, there's no hesitation. Whether you're doing a love scene, whether you're doing a funny scene, I mean, they just leapt right in. They put a lot of faith in me as a director. I mean, we had a small production, you know, relatively limited budget, and so they put a lot of faith in me, and I think both of their performances are, you know, as a person who sat in the editing room watching hours and hours and hours of footage over and over, there's almost not a dishonest moment in their entire performance that we had to sort of whittle out in editing. They're just beautiful, honest performances.
Of course, this family wouldn't have been complete without an astonishing performance by young Isaac. Can you talk a bit about discovering him and what he's brought to the film?
Well, we put out a nationwide search around the U.S. for a boy and got a number of tapes emailed to me. And I looked at 30, 40, 50, and when I finally saw Isaac's, there was something so honest and smart about his performance. And then he smiled that beautiful big smile of his at the end of his first audition. And I knew, you know, I sort of knew he was the right kid. And I will tell you, he brought, as great actors do, there are scenes in the script that changed on set because of his performance. And that's what I think sometimes what great actors do. They bring an element of themselves. They bring a perspective. And there's a wonderful scene where he goes to his bedroom for the first time and kind of breaks down. And that was, Isaac got emotional. And that allowed me as a director to change the scene on set. So he was wonderful to work with.
Of course, I think the music in the film is a very poignant communicator of those emotions, particularly the final song that lends the film its title. Can you talk a little bit about that selection and that aspect of the film?
Well, my music supervisor, PJ Bloom, I think is a real master at finding music and finding, both of us try very hard to point at the emotion, to point at what we're, without maybe going too directly at it. When he brought up the I Shall Be Released song, I said, you know, holy hell, if we can get the Dylan song, that would be just a beautiful way to end the film. And thankfully, he was able, through his connections and through his sort of stature as a music supervisor, he was able to reach out directly to Bob Dylan's manager and secure the song. And Alan does such a beautiful job, particularly when you think about, you know, he's got to, in a sense, do a performance in a recording studio 2 weeks before he actually does it on stage and then replicate it. He does a beautiful job with it.
I mean, my final question. The film's obviously a period piece, but it feels so topical right now. Was it difficult for you to avoid the label of being seen as an agenda film or a film that has a particular goal and to maintain that sense that it's just, at its heart, a love story, a story about family?
Sure. Well, I tried very, very hard in the writing of the film, on set, and then in particular in the editing of the film, to not push the agenda, to not push the politics of it. I knew that would be there by its inherent nature. It's a story about two men fighting a legal system to adopt a child. So that's there. Tried instead to really focus on the love story. Tried to focus on Alan and Garrett's relationship, their relationship with the boy, and tell that story. And I knew if we had done our job there, hopefully the sort of the political agenda would speak through and touch audiences and resonate with audiences.